I regularly get asked, how can medication work in anxiety? Some people even ask me, how can a small tablet help when I feel so anxious? In today's video, let me explain what brain studies have shown us on how medication works in anxiety. You know that a level of anxiety is normal for us humans. In fact, we wouldn't be able to function without it. But many times it becomes so much that it affects us. I am sure you have seen my video on the biology of anxiety and understood how the brain and body react when they perceive stress or threat. Do you know how many neurons are there in our brain? Type your guesses in the comment box below. There are about 86 billion neurons in our brains. We know that communication between these billions of neurons happens through chemical messages in the small gaps between the cells called the synapse, and the process is called neurotransmission. The chemicals that pass the messages are called neurotransmitters. It is also through these neurochemicals that the brain and body communicate. These signals help regulate bodily functions ranging from our heart rate to how hungry we feel. There are more than 100 neurotransmitters. They act by attaching to specific receptors on target cells. For example, serotonin will attach to serotonin receptors and trigger the target neuron. After that, their work is done and they are recycled by the body. The chemicals or neurotransmitters can act in different ways. They can either excite the target neuron to take action or inhibit the target neuron to have a relaxation-like effect. And then there are chemicals that modulate messages to many neurons at the same time. They also communicate with other neurotransmitters and enhance or reduce the function of neurotransmitters. Let me give you some examples. Serotonin is an inhibitory neurotransmitter. It helps regulate mood, behavior, sleep, memory. Dopamine, another neurotransmitter, is important for memory, behavior, learning, movement control, and you may recognize dopamine as a pleasure or reward neurotransmitter. Epinephrine, also known as adrenaline, plays a role in the body's fight or flight response. It is both a hormone and a neurotransmitter. When a person experiences stress or fear, their body releases epinephrine. This increases the heart rate and breathing and gives the muscles increased supply of energy. It also helps the brain to make quick decisions. However, chronic stress can cause the body to release too much epinephrine. Of course, other chemicals are also at play at the same time. Neurotransmitters contribute to nearly every function in the human body. An appropriate balance of neurotransmitters can help prevent certain health conditions such as depression, anxiety, amongst others. But there is no proven way to ensure that neurotransmitters are balanced and are working correctly. But when we lead a balanced life with structure, routine, consume a nutritious diet, get regular exercise, use less of alcohol, caffeine, and other substances, recognize and reduce stress, we can help keep the neurotransmitters in balance in some cases. When the symptoms of anxiety become difficult to manage and impact on our lives to the extent that we cannot function the way we were, medications can help, often in addition to other interventions like therapy. Let me give you examples. Medications that belong to the group selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, or SSRIs, boost serotonin levels by stopping the body from reabsorbing serotonin, leaving more serotonin to pass messages between the nerve cells. Another group, serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors, or SNRIs, increase serotonin and norepinephrine. Therefore, many medications can help relieve symptoms of depression, anxiety, and sometimes even chronic pain. Now that you have some understanding of how medications work in anxiety, I would like you to do this exercise today. Think of an anxious situation you have been in lately. Break down your emotions and body reactions. Write them down and against them, map which neurotransmitters may be implicated. Watch my next video here. And if you want to learn more on how to live a more fulfilled life, subscribe to my channel here And of course, if you have learned something useful, like it, share it, tell it to all the people you know. Thank you for watching.